Hello. I will talk about computational approximation to the XI model. And although my full-time occupation so far has been in physics, I also have a general interest in artificial intelligence problems. My talk will go as following. I'll first very briefly review the XI model, which is essentially based on control theory and Solomonov induction. In control theory, one needs to compute the expectation maximization of the reward, and doing so takes exponentially growing amount of computation with the distance to the horizon. And I'll show how you can go around this by evaluating the expectation approximately. Algorithmic Solomonov induction deals with algorithmic probability of certain problems, and I will introduce a Monte Carlo algorithm for sampling both programs to the algorithmic probability. And if I have time, I will show how this Monte Carlo algorithm works on a very simple problem, and maybe express my view on where how one should go toward the goal of solving a AGI problem. So almost every AI problem deals with predicting future observations. In our case, sequences of observations are represented as strings of symbols. So consider the problem of a sequence generated from some distribution mu, and a given string starts with the substring x. We want to know what the probability of this substring followed by the substring y, and if prior probability for the distribution is known, then the answer is simple. If it's unknown, the prescription is to use the universal prior of Solomonov, which is basically the sum over algorithmic probability or probabilities over all programs which output strings starting with the given substring x. The universal prior has wonderful property that conditional probabilities based on it quickly converge to conditional probabilities based on actual distribution mu. In other words, it allows us to quickly learn to predict the future observations. Pretty much every AI problem can be cast in the form of an agent seeking to maximize its reward. In our case, agent interacts with its environment in cycles. In each cycle, the agent gets a percept signal x and sends the action signal y to the environment. With every percept signal x comes reward v. So we introduce expected maximized reward v plus, for which you can write a simple recursive equation for computing the expected maximized reward. And this can be represented graphically in terms of a path on the decision tree of this agent. So along this path, x percepts are chosen from the probability distribution mu. Okay, let me say mu is the probability describing the probability measure describing probabilistic environment, and it's conditioned on the past actions of the agent. Okay, so x is chosen from mu, and y is chosen from the with the goal of maximizing the expected reward. Then the average reward along this path will give the maximized expected reward. Okay, if the probability describing the environment is not known, the probability measure is not known, again, one should use the Solomonov prior, and the agent which maximizes its reward by using the optimal Solomonov prediction scheme constitute the XI model of Marcus Hutter. This model, as this is not suitable for practical applications because it's uncomputable, but this is not a big problem. You can always choose a computable approximation for the universal crack. Another problem, as I mentioned, is the explosive growth of the computation needed to evaluate the expected reward. For this, we devise an approximate scheme. Basically, we do the following. First, we modify the prior by incorporating in a probabilistic manner the best guess of the agent about its policy. Then we sample the strings, sample path from this modified prior. We use strings with shared history to compute the expected maximized reward V plus, from which we choose the best action Y plus, and we throw away all the trajectories with suboptimal choices of the actions. Okay, don't need to know details, but it's not difficult to show that such procedure reproduces the exact expected max result when we have infinite computational resources. And if we have finite computational resources, it gives us an approximate way to evaluate the expected reward, but this can be done now with the arbitrary distant horizon. What's good about this is that algorithm is strongly biased toward the most probable path, so it means it should quickly pick up the most relevant contribution to the evaluation of the expected reward. So, the only thing which less to explain is how we are going to sample strings from the modified prior. Basically, we use the Metropolis Droplet Hastings Monte Carlo algorithm, which works as follows. Given configuration C, configuration C prime is proposed with probability Q, then this move is accepted with such probability. One can show that configurations generated in this process are both generated from the probability P of C. Just as an example, think about a single tape Turing machine. Its tape has zeros almost everywhere, and it has ones where it contains a program or results of intermediate computation. So this stretch of tape, which covers all the ones but not more than that, I call string X. Then other parameters like state of the Turing machine and position of the its head, this triple constitute the configuration. Which you can see there. We assign a probability, which is 2 to the power length of the string X. We choose Q in such a way to connect the configuration which are connected by a single computation cycle of the Turing machine. And if we start running the algorithm from the configuration corresponding to final computational cycle of the Turing machine, we will recover all the programs which gives us the desired output, and we'll sample them with frequency proportional to the algorithmic probability. Now, here I show a complete example. The representation of the computational device which I use here is very different from what I used in the previous transparency, but I won't have time to explain the connection. But basically, what we do here, we have a probabilistic model which generates samples. It's basically a subset of digits from 1 to 8. So each link has variables 0 or 1. 1 represents the link is absent. So the nodes condition like this, if this is 0, then links going to children are zeros because all the links are absent. And if this is one, then this is one or zero with some conditional probability. So what we generate subsets with digits which are correlated, and as I said, the representation is different of the computational device is different here, but the underlying principle is the same. The Monte Carlo samples the programs which produce given output and does so with a frequency proportional to the algorithmic probability. So when there are a few samples, different representations have probabilities which are not too different, so the algorithm cannot find the best one, but given many enough samples, the program with the suitable representation has much higher probability, so eventually it constructs the correct representation in this model-free approach. Okay, so I guess I'll stop. But I'll just say two goals which were pursued. To construct a computational approximation which is reasonable, meaning it reproduces the exact theory in the limit of computational resources, but on the other hand, it does not sacrifice some important real work characteristics, such as it allows us to do planning many steps ahead under constrained computational resources. I guess also.